friends, welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. As you all know, your vibe attracts your tribe, and mine has always been boho, which is an important aspect of my lifestyle. So I tend to add into my life in the form of art projects and home decor ideas. Now that spring is in its full bloom with all its splendor, I decided to combine them together. In today's video, you'll see how to repurpose old bottles and give a makeover using simple things to create a unique wall hanging that is not only economical but will also keep your face towards the sunshine. Before heading ahead with the details, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe for more such interesting creativity and hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any latest updates. So let's get started. For this project, I have been collecting bottles since a long time. You can notice few bottles have stickers while few are yet to be removed. So let's see how I removed them. Collect water in a container, add some liquid dishwasher and soak the bottles in it for 15 to 20 minutes. Gently remove the sticker from all the bottles. Still, if you find the rigid part is yet stuck, let them soak for few more minutes to soften up. Now I used back of a butter knife to scrape off the rest of sticker. Once you scraped every single bit of it, dip it in water, rinse it under running water and let it dry completely. Do the same for all the bottles. I wanted a rustic look, so collected sticks from my backyard and arranged in ascending order. Using a sponge and white acrylic color, I painted the sticks. Let them dry. Using a wet kitchen paper towel, I distressed the sticks. Unlike the previous hanging, here I distress it much more to match, as here I even used brown bottles. As you all know how to braid, used 3 strands to make a long braid, both a green and a natural one. One by one, tie both of them across the 4 sticks in this triangular pattern. This is what we'll use to hang the bottles. I used this jute twine to wrap all the bottles. I wanted to use this green bottle as it is, so didn't spray paint it. Use hot glue gun in the fashion you want to wrap the twine. Work in small paths so that the hot glue doesn't dry off. Measure and cut twine accordingly. I wanted a traditional pattern. Start to cover up the top narrow part from mouth of the bottle till its neck with a dab of glue and continue wrapping with some more twine. You can apply few drops of glue in between to keep it going. Once done, chop off the excess twine to give it a neat look. Then I selectively painted only few parts with white acrylic color and even painted in stripes on top to give it a distinct look. In the second one, I took this brown bottle and wrapped it with green twine with few drops of hot glue. I wrapped in stripes alternating with gaps. Same way, continue along the length of the bottle and as before, make it more neat by chopping the excess. I took this natural color twine and measured 5 times the length of the bottle and cut 6 such strands. Now measure the mouth of the bottle and tie knot. Make sure it fits well. To make a knot, put both ends of each strand together that you cut. Then take your hands down to the middle of that and when you get to the end, that's your halfway point, which is your natural hoop. Take this loop under the green twine, pull the strings through the loop and pull it tight to form a knot. Similarly, make such knots at equal distance along the green twine loop and place it at the mouth of the bottle. Get one strand from either side of knots and using these two strands make one such a knot. But don't tighten the knots too much as we might need to adjust them later on to be in the same level. Make other knots in the same way. Once sure they are in the same level, tighten them up. Similarly, layer by layer, make such knots. At the end, use the leftover strands to make a final big knot at the center. Now, using white acrylic color, carefully paint this outer fishnet structure. For the third one, again I used a brown bottle and measured 6 times the length and cut 16 such strands, 8 green and 8 natural color twine. Like the previous one, make a round loop across the mouth of bottle, but here form knots using 2 strands at a time. Alternate it with both the colors all round the loop. Place them evenly. Now starts the tricky part, which needs more understanding, as it's time for some macrame. So be careful to make it a cakewalk. To make it easier for you, let me individually show you using these 4 strands. For a basic square knot, you need 4 strands. Remember, middle 2 strands always stay together. Think of them as one. Then you can start either with right or left. I'll start with right. Make something like this, which resembles the shape of number 4. Then take the strand on the left and go over the tail of 4 and underneath the 2 strands that are held together and up through the hole of the 4 and pull them up and tight together, which is one half of a square knot. Now, for the other half, I'll just reverse that. This time, 4 will be on the left side and this right strand will go over the tail, underneath everything else and up through the hole of 4 and pull them tight. And that is a finished square knot. Keep alternating back and forth the same way as long as you want. I made 2 such square knots. After you are done with 2 square knots for all of them, now take 4 neighboring strands, 2 of green and 2 of natural. Continued with square knots till the neck of the bottle, which was 8 square knots. Next we'll do spiral knot. In fact, you already know this. Start with any one side like before. Here it's right, same like square knot, but instead of reversing, keep repeating on the same side. As you go on repeating, gradually you'll notice a twisting. Spiral knot is in fact one half of a square knot. Once you reach the neck of the bottle, I again alternated and used neighboring 4 strands to form spiral knots. All my spiral knots were of different lengths. Using hot glue, fix their ends, and after gluing all of them, with the remaining, I made a knot at the center and chopped them off asymmetrically using pair of scissors. Just to give a more tighter look around the bottle's neck, I used few single twine strands over and under these knots, alternating with both the colors. Tie knots and hide underneath the square knots for a neat look. And using white acrylic color to highlight just the outer border of spiral knots. For the final one, I wish to color the bottle. Like me, you can spray paint it, for which use a clean bottle. You can even clean it using alcohol and use gloves to prevent exposure. First, sand the bottle using sandpaper, which helps the paint to hold better. Dust it well with a towel before spraying. Now spray it from a distance to avoid dripping and go through the instructions written on the back of the bottle. Choose a well-ventilated area and protect the surface you are working on to avoid spillage. After one coat, let it dry for 15 to 20 minutes and apply further coats depending on how opaque you want it to be. I applied 3 coats. Once you have your white painted bottle, Measure green twine twice the length of bottle and as before, knot a circular loop and make knots around the loop. Only difference here is we have it at the bottom of the bottle instead of top. Now using two strands from adjacent knots, make one such knot and repeat the same all round. Keep repeating the same till you reach the end. Fix all the ends using hot glue. Now apply glue joining the ends and fix natural color twine along and keep rolling horizontally. Measure the distance from top and cut 4 to 5 strands of the same length and fix them in stripes using hot glue vertically, alternating with equal gaps to cover up the bottle. Now repeat these horizontal stripes up till the mouth of the bottle to create an overall crisscross pattern. And you're all done. Now it's time to hang these bottles to the hanger we made earlier. First, arrange the bottles in the way you wish. Take your time for the combination you like the most. I kept it uneven. Now I prefer to hang the bottles using a braid in this way so that it's adjustable and it's easier to remove as well. So even if you want to use bottles for some other purpose or any other decor idea, you can always take it out and use. Just to fill in the space, I used pieces of twine and made knots. You can see I made them in two different ways, did it all the way, alternating with both the colors, and filled the bottles with flower sticks. Hope you liked this video. If yes, as always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you haven't already. If you wish to follow me on my social media for more updates, links are provided in the description box. You can check out more such easy and quick projects on my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. See you soon in my next video. Till then, live, love and laugh.